go. And the important thing was always to tell this story, these small stories of this kid that had such large ramifications for all of us.
As it entered the new decade of the 1990s, The Wonder Years remained a steady ratings winner for ABC. But the series had a built-in expiration date. The young leads were growing up, and the Wonder Years couldn't last forever. In the summer of 1991, the cast and crew of The Wonder Years reconvened to begin work on the show's fifth season, but they were in for a surprise.
I grew literally 6 inches between April, when the season ended, and August, when we came back. And Sheila, who's the head wardrobe woman, looked at me and she shrieked. She went, "Oh!"
Over the summer, my best friend had gained two things: a new set of contact lenses and a new set of hormones.
I could be home right now making time with Julie Zeller.
Oh, you're dreaming, pal.
That's what happens in life. Dynamics change and people grow at different rates, and that means different things and it affects relationships in different ways. And that just, you know, they worked it in. It was part of it.
The actors weren't just outgrowing their wardrobes. They needed new, more mature storylines as well.
We had to be really careful about the stories that we were telling, but we also wanted to be honest. I remember we were doing an episode one time where Kevin touches a girl's breast for the first time. And we would get these notes from standards and practice saying, "But this is Kevin Arnold. He can't touch a girl's breast."
I'm sorry.
We tried to be honest and tried to, you know, deal with the subject matter in a delicate way.
In 1992, Fred Savage experienced his own growth spurt, just as Joss Saviano had done the previous year.
I miss you today. I thought about you in chemistry.
Yeah, I thought about you in biology.
As Kevin Arnold was maturing into a young man, The Wonder Years began to lose some of its magic, and by the sixth season, the audience was losing interest.
Wait. I love this song.
Look, Winnie, are we really going to keep doing this?
Doing what?
Well, you know, starting, stopping.
Mostly stopping.
Don't you think it's time we went a little further?
The kid's voice is going to change. Then the whole patina of the show changes. You can still write good stuff. It can still be a good show. But something is missing. And because when his voice changes, there's a sense of innocence that has vanished.
Hey. I just want you to know.
The on-set atmosphere also suffered a blow that year when a crew member accused Fred Savage and Jason Hervey of sexual harassment. It was a terrible shock for the tight-knit group when the scandal was splashed all over the tabloids.
I think we felt a tremendous sense of betrayal, especially because we all cared so much about the people who were involved.
The show's extended family rallied around the boys, and the matter was legally resolved behind closed doors. But with creative difficulties still plaguing the series, the cast began to hear rumors that The Wonder Years would soon come to an end.
The actors really didn't know what would happen if there'd be another year, and I think there's real mixed emotions about what they wanted.
The one-hour final episode of the sixth season dealt with Kevin's difficult relationship with his father.
You know what your problem is?
Yeah, I can't stand it here.
You think you're too good for this job?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Because maybe this job is good enough for you, but it's not good enough for me.
Fine. You don't want to work here. I don't want you here.
And after 17 years of living under my father's thumb...
Okay. I quit. I'm out of here.
It also focused on his turbulent romance with Winnie Cooper.
Winnie.
Almost complete, a decision still had not been made about the show's future.
What upset me was just that they didn't have the courtesy to decide. Just decide, are you going to run it out? You know, do you think that it's over? You know, that's fine. It's just don't end it like this. End it with, you know, with a kind of dignity.
Filming concluded with a shot of all the characters watching a parade. Soon, Bob Brush and his team would write the narration that would either set up the next season or reveal the ultimate fates of Kevin Arnold and his family and friends. In the spring of 1993, Daniel Stern recorded the narration that would wrap up the sixth season of The Wonder Years. By the time he had finished, there was no doubt left about the show's fate.
The story of The Wonder Years had been told, and it was time to make a graceful exit. And that's what we did.
Karen's son was born that September. I gotta say, I think he looks like me. Poor kid. Mom, she did well. Businesswoman, board chairman, grandmother, cooker of mashed potatoes. The Wainers stayed on in furniture. Wood seemed to suit him. In fact, he took over the factory 2 years later, when Dad passed away.
Carol and Neil always wanted that to be the end. You know, that, you know, because that's one of the major things in a kid's life is when a parent dies.
Winnie left the next summer to study art history in Paris. Still, we never forgot our promise. We wrote to each other once a week for the next 8 years. I was there to meet her when she came home, with my wife and my first son, 8 months old. Growing up happens in a heartbeat. One day you're in diapers, next day you're gone. But the memories of childhood stay with you for the long haul.
When I got to the last speech, I went to do the, to read it, and it was very emotional. I mean, you know, like I was trying to not cry during the thing. It was, and then Bob Brush was sitting there, and he was getting weepy.
And the thing is, after all these years, I still look back with wonder.
The last line of the show was something like, hey, a kid comes in a door and says, hey, Dad, come play catch with me, in voiceover. They asked if my kid Henry would read that line. So me and Henry finished the show up. I'll be right there.
After production had wrapped, ABC officially announced what had already been decided. The Wonder Years had been canceled.
There was a big cry, and we all were talking. It was very much like a cry of happiness. We'll miss you, what a great run, you know?
When the last episode aired on May 12, 1993, it meant the dissolution of an off-screen family that had nurtured young actors from childhood through adolescence.
Our last wrap party was just so cheesy and sentimental. I mean, it was so like, I love you, man. And it's true. It was 7 years with the same people. It was such a wonderful experience that it was so sad to see it go.
But unlike many child stars, the kids of the Wonder Years had no trouble moving on with their lives.
I had a really nice career doing films and doing other series.